Hello, everyone, and welcome to the very first episode of Historical Top 10s, where we look at the top 10 plays from a random week in a random season of the NFL. For today's video, we're looking at the top 10 plays from Week 5 of the 1981 season. Coming in at number 10, we start in Miami. Late first quarter, score tied at 7 between the Jets and the Dolphins, and check out this catch by Wesley Walker. It's not a well-thrown ball at all by quarterback Richard Todd, but it's an unbelievable adjustment by Walker here to make this grab and score from 11 yards out to give the Jets the lead. This will not be the last you see of Wesley Walker here in this one. At number 9, we go to the Meadowlands. Packers at the Giants, with the Packers leading 20-7. Lynn Dickey drops back and finds John Jefferson in between two Giants defenders, somehow breaks out of it as nobody can make the tackle, and Jefferson scores his first touchdown as a member of the Green Bay Packers. He had a bunch of them over the previous 3 years with the Chargers, and now he's got one with the Pack. Green Bay takes a 27-7 lead and wins this game 27-14. Coming in at number 8, let's go back to Miami. Check out this impressive catch by Nat Moore down the field. Don Strock drops back, throws it up to his former Pro Bowl receiver, and Moore makes the grab in double coverage. It's a 47-yard catch to get his team into Jets territory. Moore had an incredible game in this one, 7 catches for 210 yards and 2 touchdowns, and this was his best play of the day. We'll come back to this game later on. At number 7, let's take a trip down to the Superdome. Steelers against the Saints. Pittsburgh holding on to a 13-6 lead in the fourth quarter, and they're about to get some insurance here as Terry Bradshaw had a great game in this one, 19 for 28 for 276 and 2 touchdowns. This was his biggest play of the day. It's a 47-yard strike to John Stallworth to give Pittsburgh a 2-score lead as the Steelers win this game 20-6 to get above 500. Coming in at number 6, let's head to the Astrodome. Bengals taking on the Oilers. Houston trails 10-7 in the third quarter, but that's about to change right here. Check out Carl Roaches. He gets some blockers, he gets by the kicker Jim Breach, and takes it 96 yards for the touchdown, the first of his NFL career. Houston retakes the lead, and they wind up winning this one 17-10. At number 5, we're going to Anaheim. The Rams lead the Browns 27-10 late in the fourth, and it's over at this point, but look at this incredible touchdown catch by future Hall of Fame tight end Ozzie Newsome. It's a 38-yard pass from Brian Sipe, the MVP of the league in 1980, and it's a great diving catch in the end zone to cut the deficit. It wouldn't be enough, however, as the Rams would win this one 27-16. Coming in at number 4, check out this wacky play in Washington. Terry Metcalf on the carry, playing his first season in the league since 1977, and Ronnie Lott comes up with one of his signature hits. Ball pops out, Dwight Hicks catches the pop-up on the fly, and it's off to the races. It's an 80-yard touchdown for Hicks to give the 49ers a 14-0 lead in the first quarter, and they would go on to win the game 30-17. At number 3, I told you earlier that Wesley Walker would make another appearance on this episode, and here it is, one of the wildest touchdown catches you've probably never seen before. Start of the fourth quarter, Jets down by 7. Richard Todd makes a poor decision on this throw, but it's batted up twice in the air by the Dolphins defenders, and Wesley Walker makes an incredible diving catch in the end zone to tie this game up. Check it out from the reverse angle. That's safety Glenn Blackwood on the first deflection, and Walker ends up saving what should have been a pick and turns it into a touchdown. But we are not done with this game yet. At number 2, we've got another play from this game here in Miami. Jets trail by 7 with less than 2 minutes to go, and I have no idea how Bobby Jones makes this catch. Richard Todd throws it up into double coverage, and Jones somehow comes down with it for a 36-yard touchdown to tie the game up at 28 apiece. That would be the only touchdown that Jones scored for the Jets all season, but man, that was a great one. The game would end with a 28-28 tie. And coming in at number 1, check out this play from Busch Stadium between the Cardinals and the Cowboys. Third quarter, game tied at 10, Jim Hart looks for Roy Green in the back of the end zone, and it's an incredible one-handed diving grab. He gets both feet in bounds and gives the Cardinals the lead, and St. Louis would go on to win this game 20-10. That's all for this edition of Historical Top 10s. If you like this series, be sure to like, subscribe, and hit that notification icon so you don't miss the next episode. Until next time, signing off.